The Canon EOS RP is a full frame mirrorless camera that's gonna run you about $1,000 or even less depending on sales. But with all these new cameras being announced and coming out, is this thing still worth buying? Let's talk about it. So if this happens to be your guys' first time to this channel, first of all, thank you for clicking on today's video. But my name is Johnny, and on this channel, I'm all about helping other creators create the best looking content that they possibly can. And sometimes that involves talking about cameras, and today we are talking about the Canon EOS RP. Now on my channel already, I actually have an in-depth review of the Canon EOS RP already, and then also another one on the EOS R. If that interests you guys, you should definitely check those out. But in today's video is gonna be a more high level overview of the EOS RP, just talking about some of my experiences with this camera since I've owned it, who I think this camera is kind of perfect for, and then honestly, just with all these new cameras coming out and everything like that, should you still spend your money on this or should you buy this? So I originally picked up the EOS RP because I had the EOS R and I was running into some situations where I wish I had a second camera body. So instead of buying two EOS Rs, I figured why not get the EOS RP. First of all, I can test it out for you guys, see how I like it, but also I would save some money because I know I wasn't gonna be using this specific camera every single day like my EOS R. And honestly, I've been surprised how much I like this camera and I think it's really underrated. Now I'm gonna try my best to not make this an EOS R versus EOS RP video, but if that's something you guys are interested in and you want me to record, let me know in the comments below and maybe I'll do it. So let me talk to you guys about a few things that first come to mind when I think of what do I like about this camera. If you've ever heard me talk about the EOS RP, one of my favorite things about it is honestly the size. You are getting a full frame mirrorless camera and this thing is tiny. It is smaller than the EOS R. Look at the size of it compared to my iPhone. Like this thing is, I mean, it's small. Obviously it's thicker than my phone, but this thing is, I mean, it's shorter than my iPhone. I love that this thing doesn't take up much room in your camera bag, or honestly, if you even just wanna throw this in your normal backpack, you don't wanna bring your big camera bag with you, or maybe you're a lady, you want a camera that can just fit in your purse. This thing is small, but it still feels great in the hand, and it does not feel cheap either. Another thing that's great and why this is such a good vlogging camera as well is it has that flip out screen. So if you are filming yourself, or maybe you're trying to get a certain composition, taking some photos lower than you, higher than you, whatever, the flip out screen is awesome. I've actually used this camera quite a few times if I'm doing some overhead shots just because it's small and it's lightweight, but it's really nice to have that flip out screen so I can kind of see what I'm shooting when this camera is above me. Another really important thing to note here is that it does have the new RF mount, which is basically Canon's new camera line. So all of Canon mirrorless cameras are using the RF mount now, which is a newer mount compared to the EF mount, which is what was on like a 5D or a 1DX, things like that, which is basically what Canon lenses were for the past like 10 or 12 years, or maybe even longer than that. But the RF lenses that are coming out now are basically like the newest lenses that Canon are making. They are beautiful, they look amazing, they're super crisp, the apertures on them are insane. So if you decide to pick up some of the new RF lenses, and then you eventually want to upgrade the camera body, those lenses are going to work on all the new Canon mirrorless cameras. And yeah, they are sick. I recently picked up the 15-35, which actually I'm gonna have a review coming out on that very soon. But yeah, the new lenses are awesome and it kind of future-proofs you so you don't have to be afraid that the lenses you're buying for this, you won't be able to use later down the line. I guarantee you if you buy some RF lenses, those are gonna outlive this camera right here. So get a good lens and it's only going to make the quality of the images out of this thing even better. Another thing that's awesome too is if you don't wanna invest in some of those RF lenses yet, because honestly they are very new and they're very expensive, you can actually get an RF to an EF adapter so you can use some of those older model lenses that you maybe have already, or if you're someone like me, you didn't really want to invest in the RF glass quite yet. So I picked this up along with an older model lens, and that's what I used on my camera for like the first year that I had it, and it still works great. The next thing, the images coming out of this camera look amazing. Like I mentioned before, I use this for both photos and video quite often. So for photos, you're getting a 26 megapixel sensor, which is great, especially if you're kind of in the day and age now where most of your photos are either going to Instagram or your website or going digital. 26 megapixels megapixels is probably more than enough for what you need. For whatever reason, I actually end up taking a lot of my photos with this camera. I think it's kind of just because a lot of times my EOS R is just kind of set up on my tripod. It's just kind of ready to go for video over there. So if I need to just take a quick picture for Instagram or Twitter, whatever, I usually just kind of have this set up ready to go for photos, and I'm totally comfortable taking photos for this. And honestly, a lot of my photos that you see over my Instagram were probably taken with this camera right here. Now, as far as the video goes, this does shoot 4K, but just like the EOS R, it has a very large crop on it. So I never touch the 4K feature on this. If I'm ever shooting video, I'm either shooting 1080p, 24 frames per second, which you can actually add now because of a firmware update, which is a big win, or I'm shooting 1080p, 60 frames per second, so I can get some good looking slow motion. Now, I will say that the footage that I think that comes out of this is pretty impressive. I was actually shocked how well it actually looked and how well it compared to the EOS R. It doesn't really have any crazy features, like it doesn't have C-Log, it doesn't have the best bit rate or the best codecs for the video quality. But with all that being said, if I had to get a video done just using this specific camera, I definitely could get it done, and I think it would look pretty good as well. All right guys, so I actually tried to kind of match the same exact angle as the rest of this video, but this is actually being filmed with the Canon EOS RP. And honestly, I feel like it looks pretty similar. I think it looks pretty good. So this is the neutral picture profile on the Canon EOS RP, but without a doubt, the quality of this camera I think is there, but you know, I do have a very nice light with it along with a nice lens on it as well. But the image quality coming out of the EOS RP is looking pretty good. All right guys, so this is actually on the Canon EOS RP. Just walking outside, kind of just want to show you guys what the image looks like. It's about 6 o'clock, so the sun is starting to set a little bit, but you know, that's some shade, that's some sunlight right there. I'm trying to adjust it so you guys can see what it actually looks like, but I think the image quality looks pretty good considering the sun is pretty harsh right there. So this is on a neutral picture profile. Just want to show you guys kind of what the footage looks like. So yeah, not too bad. Now, a question that I'm starting to receive pretty much every single day, whether it be in my DMs or on my comments or anything like that, is, Johnny, I want to take cool photos. I want to take photos of cars, or I want to take portraits of other people, or I want to vlog. What camera should I buy? And that is such a hard question to answer because for everybody, it's going to be something different depending on what your experience is with cameras already. What is your budget going to be, and what are you going to actually use your camera for? So instead of just blindly saying, well, you should go buy this camera, let's talk about this one specifically. Who do I think this camera is for, and who would I suggest kind of looking into this? This is a fantastic entry-level camera that I would say is kind of like a stepping stone into the higher end cameras. So maybe you're someone who's made a lot of videos using their phone or an older DSLR, or even like maybe some action cameras. If you want to start taking some portrait photography, maybe you want to start vlogging and start a YouTube channel. If that kind of sounds like where you're at and you're trying to take your stuff to the next level, I think this might be a really good choice. Or maybe you're someone like me who has a higher end camera already, and then they want a second camera body that they don't want to spend as much money on because they're not using this thing every single day. Again, I think this is a really good option. If you go back and check out my RP review video and you look through the comments, I can't tell you how many people on that video have mentioned that they picked up the EOS RP and they absolutely love it. So do I think the RP is the best camera out there for everybody? No, absolutely not. But you're gonna get some good photos, you're gonna get some good videos, and it's kind of like you're getting a camera that can do all those things really well. It just doesn't have all the crazy bells and whistles with it. So you're not gonna get like C-Log or any crazy picture profiles or all these crazy video qualities and codecs. You're not gonna have a shutter that can shoot like 20 frames a second if you're like shooting some action sports and things like that. But if you're in the entry level position, trying to take your photos and videos to the next level, and you want a camera that's going to set you up for the future, I think the EOS RP is a great option, and you definitely should consider it because honestly, all these new cameras are coming out, like the EOS R5 and the EOS R6, but those cameras are overkill for what a lot of people need. So if you're kind of getting into this and you want to have one of those cameras eventually, I think this is a perfect stepping stone. Get a camera like this for a price like this. Learn this camera inside and out, and then when your skills start getting limited by this camera's features, that's when you want to start looking to upgrade to something else. So hopefully that made sense, guys. I try to make this a little bit different than a review because, you know, I already have that review out, but I kind of just wanted to touch on this camera a little bit more because I've definitely received more questions about the RP than any other camera that I own or any other camera out there, honestly. So since I've had this camera for a little bit longer, I figured I'd just put out another video talking about it because I think this thing is still worth the money and a lot of people could get some use out of a camera like this. So guys, if you do have any more questions about the Canon EOS RP, let me know in the comments below and I'll be sure to respond to you guys' questions down there. And if you guys do want another video like I suggested about the EOS RP versus the R, maybe I'll kind of get that video in the works. But guys, that is it for today's video and that is all I have to say about the RP for now. Hopefully you enjoyed watching and you were able to take something away from it. If you did enjoy today's video, will you drop it a thumbs up? That really helps the channel out. If you're new around here, consider hitting that sub button. I'd really appreciate it. I try to make content trying to help other creators create better looking content. That is a mouthful. My name is Johnny. I will see you guys in the next video. Peace.